To him belong the heavens and the earth. The ever living, he is the first. He's the owner of mercy. He sent his messenger.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back, brothers and sisters, to another episode in this amazing series where we shall go through Riyadus Salihin with Sheikh Haitham al-Haddad. Sheikh Haitham al-Haddad is currently based in the UK and is on the board of the Islamic Sharia Council of Britain and is also the founder of the website www.islam21c.com. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
We needed to come into this episode just to finish the hadith because it has such amazing detail and importance of the good deeds and the bad deeds and what will we get from them.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, alhamdulillah wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah. As we said that we discussed the hadith number 9, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if two Muslims are fighting with each other and one kills the other person, both of them will go to hellfire. Why? Because the victim who was killed, he was planning to kill. So he was what? Planning, intending. So after hadith number 9, we said it is good to speak about hadith number 11. And inshallah we'll read hadith number 10. Because hadith number 11 is very linked, very attached to hadith number 9. I don't know why Imam Nawawi mentioned it after that. He could mention it immediately after hadith number 9. Allahu alam, he is a scholar. Maybe there is a reason for this and I did not understand it. Maybe, Allahu alam. Anyway, so hadith number 11 is the hadith that we read it last time. Hadith ibn Abbas radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam said, inna allaha kataba al-hasanati wa sayyat. Allah decreed the hasanat and sayyat. Allah defined the hasanat and sayyat. فَمَنْ هَمَّ بِحَسَنَةٍ, the one who intended to do a good deed, but he didn't do it, he will get one hasana. Hasana means a reward. Yeah? A single reward. And if he does it, he will get 10 rewards. And we have explained this. Then, as we said, let us look at the other side. What Allah Jalla wa Ala said about sayyat. So, the hadith says, فَمَنْ هَمَّ بِسَيِّئَةٍ وَلَمْ يَعْمَلْهَا, the one who wants to do an evil deed. Obviously, if he wants to do an evil deed, he needs to get a sayyah, because he planned to do an evil deed, as he planned to do a good deed, and he will get one good deed, even if he doesn't do it. So, a person who planned to do an evil deed will get a sayyah, an evil reward for him. No, Allah Jalla wa Ala did not say this. Allah Jalla wa Ala did not decree this. Why is this? Because the person who refrained from doing an evil deed, it means that this person refrained from it for something. Mm-hmm. What is it? For Allah. Normally the person refrains from doing a bad deed is because of something else.
There has to be a reason.
And normally, people refrain from bad deeds because of Allah Jalla wa Ala. In fact, refraining from doing a bad deed might be a huge hasana, or might be number of hasana, not just one single. That's why Allah Jalla wa Ala says, وَلِمَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ جَنَّتَانَ, the one who fears what? The status of Allah Jalla wa Ala, or to stand before Allah Jalla wa Ala on the day of resurrection. This can be understood both ways. That he fears the day of resurrection when he is going to stand before Allah Jalla wa Ala, and Allah Jalla wa Ala is holding him accountable and Allah Jalla wa Ala is reminding him of his sayyat. So this person, he refrained from the sayyat because of this. He will get to Jannah. Which means that going against the desire because of Allah Jalla wa Ala, stopping yourself from the sayyah, which is maybe lovely, which may fulfill the desire, which may be a desire itself, you will get a huge reward, either one single huge reward or number of good deeds. In the other ayah, Allah Jalla Ala says, وَأَمَّا مَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ وَنَهَى النَّفْسَ عَنِ الْهَوَى فَإِنَّ الْجَنَّةَ هِيَ الْمَأْوَى. Here Allah Jalla Ala said, the one who refrains from doing bad deeds because of Allah, again, because of maqam rabbihi, Allah's status, Allah's glory. He was so embarrassed to do this before Allah. Or because he was afraid of standing before Allah Jalla Ala on the day of resurrection, he stopped himself from doing these bad deeds. فَإِنَّ الْجَنَّةَ هِيَ الْمَأْوَى. Here, Allah Jalla wa'ala mentioned one Jannah. Al-Jannah here is jinns. So he will be dwelling in the Jannah. Mm-hmm. There is no contradiction between this ayah and the other ayah, Jannatan, and here Jannah. Here, because Allah Jalla wa'ala was talking about the jinns of Al-Jannah, the type. What kind of reward he will be getting is the Jannah. And Jannah, hiya al-ma'wa, means he will be dwelling in it forever. And that's why, subhanallah, this hadith shows the generosity of Allah Jalla wa'ala. Allah Jalla wa'ala, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if the person wants to do a bad deed, yet he refrained from doing that bad deed, which means he refrained from doing it because of Allah. Yes, just by his intention, he will get one hasana. Subhanallah. Not that he will get nothing, he will be neutral. No, he will get one hasana.
The mercy and generosity.
The mercy and generosity. However, if he does it, he will get how many? One. Yes. وَلَا يُجْزَى الَّذِينَ عَمِلُوا السَّيَّاتِ إِلَّا مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. Those who used to do bad deeds, they will get whatever they used to do. Yes. And وَمَنْ جَاءَ بِالسَّيَّةِ فَلَا يُجْزَى إِلَّا مِثْلَهُ. And the one who commits a sayyah, he will be just rewarded for it by a single sayyah as well. This is not even justice. This is what? Justice and generosity and mercy of Allah Jalla wa'ala.
This deal, if you like, is completely in our favor.
Subhanallah al-Azim. And that's why, inshaAllah, we need to discuss maybe what is needed to be discussed in this hadith. The level of intentions. Yeah? Which level of intention grants you hasana? Which level of intention grants you a sayyi'ah? Or which level of intention grants you a hasana instead of what? Instead of the sayyi'ah. The conclusion of this hadith is, or the end of this hadith, Allah Jalla wa'ala will give the person, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, Allah Jalla wa'ala will give the person one single sayyah for the sayyah that he has committed. Yeah? Okay. Now, the scholars also discussed a very important point, which is the hadith says, man hamma, the one who intends to do a good deed. Is this any kind of intention to do a good deed? On the other side, the hadith says, man hamma bi sayyatin falam ya'malha. The one who intends to do a bad deed, yet he didn't do it. Why he didn't do it? We need to understand. Is it because if, imagine, the hadith that we have mentioned, hadith Abi Bakr and Nafi' ibn al-Harith, if two Muslims are fighting, and one kills the other, both of them will go to hellfire.
Exactly.
But
he didn't do the bad deed in this case.
Yes. This is the point. So the victim, he didn't do the bad deed. So will he get a hasana? The Prophet ﷺ said he will be in the fire of hell. How come? So this needs explanation. Okay. The scholars defined, or the scholars explained, that there are different levels of intention or thoughts. Yeah? Or plan. So they said that the very first of intention, yes, is al-khatira. Right at the beginning, an idea came to his mind, a passing thought. Now, he didn't still think about it. He didn't even capture it. And this is wiswas. Inshallah, we can discuss it after the break. Inshallah.
Brothers and sisters, please come back to us after the break, where we should continue to look at the chapter of Ikhlas. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says in the Quran that he created the death and the life for the purpose of testing us.
Taqwa and truthfulness, humility and repentance, kindness and gratefulness.
Are you prepared for the final exam? Are you ready?
Generosity and tenderness give true value to life.
To answer the most important exam that you will ever face.
Dr. Jonathan Cazales.
Live your life on purpose.
Learn to utilize every moment of life to make it meaningful and precious in Live Your Life on Purpose. Every Sunday at 11:30 p.m. and repeat telecast at 12:30 p.m. UK on Peace TV. The voice of truth.
But Allah does not look at your face, but rather Allah looks at your heart and looks at your action.
We Muslims know life is a test.
And so in order for us to have peace, there must be standards, there must be truth.
The voice of justice.
Indeed, to all nations we send a messenger that they will call people to worship one God, Allah.
The one who is the only one who can grant true peace.
That we are looking for.
The voice of peace.
The last and final instruction manual for the human being, it is the glorious Quran.
The voice standing up for all of humanity against all falsehood. Islamic Voice. Every Sunday to Friday at 10 p.m. and repeat telecast at 7 a.m. UK on Peace TV.
Where truth is hidden, misleading quotations create confusion. Where truth is hidden, lack of knowledge and wisdom cause upheaval and commotion. Where truth is hidden, manipulated scriptures and twisted facts emerge. This very hidden truth creates false propaganda, mayhem, chaos, disorder, and turmoil in our lives and the world order. But is there anyone with courage and wisdom? What is the truth, and who has the courage to expose it? Because it's the right to know the truth.
Watch Truth Prevail and Lies Perish in Truth Exposed by Dr. Zakir Naik, next on Peace TV.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome again, brothers and sisters, to the continuation of this discussion between myself and Sheikh Azim al-Haddad. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullah.
We were just going through the hadith which tells us that the deal is completely in our favor when it comes to the good and bad deeds.
Yes. Hadith Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhu. We said that the conclusion of this hadith is, or the end of this hadith, Allah jalla wa ala will give the person, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allah jalla wa ala will give the person one single sayya for the sayya that he has committed. Yeah? Okay. Now, the scholars also discussed a very important point. It is good to mention it now in this just half episode, which is the hadith says, man hamma, the one who intends to do a good deed. Is this any kind of intention to do a good deed? On the other side, the hadith says, man hamma bi sayyatin falam ya'malha, the one who intends to do a bad deed, yet he didn't do it. Why he didn't do it? We need to understand. Is it because, if imagine the hadith that we have mentioned, hadith Abi Bakr and Nafi' ibn al-Harith, if two Muslims are fighting and one kills the other, both of them will go to hellfire.
Exactly.
But
he didn't do the bad deed in this case.
Yes. This is the point. So the victim, he didn't do the bad deed. So will he get a hasana? The Prophet ﷺ said he will be in the fire of hell. How come? So this needs explanation. Okay. The scholars define, or the scholars explain, that there are different levels of intention or thoughts, or plan. So they said that the very first of intention, is al-khatira. Right at the beginning, an idea came to his mind, a passing thought. Now, he didn't still think about it. He didn't even capture it. And this is wiswas. Most of the scholars said, even this, he will not get a hasana for it, because it is just a passing by.
In and out.
In and out. And by the way, many brothers always complain that they have doubts. And I tell them that, be careful, these are not doubts, these are just passing thoughts. Okay? And those passing thoughts happen frequently, come to us. They used to come to the Sahaba as well. When they said, Ya Rasulullah, sometimes we think of things that we prefer to fall from the heavens rather than acting upon them. So these are just passing thoughts. The person will never be punished for them. And some scholars said that he will not even be rewarded for them. Now let us move. He captured the thought.
So this is next level.
This is the next level. He captured the thought. And now he started to think about either doing it or not doing it. But he captured it. This is a higher level. Now, most of the scholars said, if that thought was a good deed, and he was thinking of doing it, or thinking of not doing it, shall I do or not? This will be recorded for him as a hasana. Some scholars said, What about the bad deed? No, it will not be recorded for him. Okay, let us move. Now, then this person moved to another level, which is, let me do it. Now, he wanted to do it. Not confirmed, he wanted to do it.
So he had a little bit of intention.
So he has a little bit of intention, and he is inclined, towards what? Doing it. So the scholar said, this is the ham. All of the scholars said, this is the ham. This is the one who, intended to do a good deed. He will get the reward of a good deed.
Even if it didn't happen.
Even if it didn't happen. Because now he said, I want to do it. Okay? He's not confirmed 100% that he wants to do it. What about the sayyi'ah? He wants to do it. This is again what is mentioned in the hadith, that he decided to do it. It is not a very strong decision, but he decided to do the sayyi'ah. He refrained from the sayyi'ah. See, he refrained.
So he actively refrained.
So he actively refrained. Then it will be considered for him as what? As a hasan. It is clear. Now, let us move to the fourth level. The fourth level, he said, 100% I will do it. So, not just took the decision, it's better for me to do it. No, 100% do it. Let me just start. He has not started yet. Let me start. This is another level, and this is a confirmation of what is mentioned in this hadith, that if it was a good deed, it will be recorded for him as a good deed. If it was a bad deed, and after the confirmation, he wants to do it, he refrained, it will be counted for him as what?
Hasana.
As a good deed. Tayyib. Some scholars said, however, if he was thinking, let us start from the beginning, a passing thought about a sayyi'ah, just a passing by thought, then he captured it. He started to think about it. Captured it. Then he said, I am inclined to do it. So still, he will not receive a sayyi'ah for it. He's inclined now to do a sayyi'ah. He will not receive a sayyi'ah for it. Now he confirmed that he will do it, and it is a strong decision. He confirmed. Not just he wanted, he confirmed. And he started to think of how to do it. So the decision to be taken is 100%. Is it going to be a sayyah for him? Some scholars said yes.
Because he reached that level now.
Because he reached that level. Allah Jalla wa'ala says in the Quran about Mecca, وَمَنْ يُرِدْ فِيهِ بِإِلْحَادٍ بِظُلْمٍ نُذِقْهُ مِنْ عَذَابٍ أَلِيمٍ. The one who intends to do ظلم, injustice, سيئة, mischief in Al-Haram, yes, he will receive punishment. So they said here, yurid means he wanted to do it. He confirmed to do it. Okay? Now, the fifth level is the person started to carry out some actions in order to do the bad deed. So he's now moved from sphere of planning internally, yeah, or thinking or taking the decision internally to carry out certain actions. This person will definitely be sinful, yeah, and will definitely be rewarded. Rewarded if he was planning and he started to do the good deed, and he will be sinful because he started to do the bad deed. Now, some scholars said he will be punished, or he will receive sayyat, yes, bad deeds, for whatever he does so far.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah? Whatever he does so far. For example, this person who was fighting the other Muslim, obviously he will prepare his sword, his weapons. He will buy them. Yeah? He will move. So all of these are actions to do an evil deed. So all of these are evil deeds as well. That's why the scholars of Usul al-Fiqh, they said, whatever leads to wajib is wajib. Whatever leads to good is good. Whatever leads to bad is bad.
Mm-hmm.
So the means take the ruling of what? Of the goals. Yeah? The means? In Islam, we don't say that the end justifies the mean. There are some restrictions. But here, the end is evil. So the path to that evil thing is also evil, and the person will receive sayyat for it. Some other scholars said, no, he will be also receiving sayyat as if he has reached the final destination, as if he has committed the end as well. If he, they said, if he was stopped from doing the end, okay, by something out of his own will. Yeah? So, they said if a person wanted to steal, so he went, he planned, yeah, in his mind. And then he started to carry out the steps. He took material to steal, and gloves, etc.
He left his house.
And he left his house. He moved, all of these are sayyat for him.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah? And then he wanted to go to the car that he wants to steal. He didn't find it. Or he heard the police coming. So he was stopped from doing it, not because he didn't want to do it, but because of what?
Other factors.
An external factor. So they said he will what? He will receive that punishment. The Prophet ﷺ said, Al-Qatil wal-Maqtul, the one who killed and the killed person, both of them will be in the fire of hell. Why? Because this person, he was doing, actually, fighting. Yeah? But it happened that he could not kill. It happened out of his own will. Yeah? Out of his own will, he went to steal the car. He couldn't steal it. Out of his own will. Otherwise, had it been there, he would have done it.
So all the factors that happened that were not in his control stopped him doing it.
Yes. It is against his control. Yeah? He might even say, wow, I missed it.
Mm.
See, he will be what? Sad that he could not do the evil deed. And this what is mentioned in Hadith Al-Qatil wal-Maqtul. Yeah, the murderer or the killer and the killed, both of them are in the fire of hell because the one who was killed, he wanted to do it.
Yes.
And this shows the importance of intention and the danger of intention and how intention can put the person up or down.
Jazakallah khair. Brothers and sisters, please come back to us in the next episode where we shall continue in this chapter of Ikhlas. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
He created the universe. To him belong the heavens and the earth. The ever-living, he is the first. He's the owner of mercy. He sent his messengers to warn his creatures of the grave dangers of worshiping other than Allah. There is none greater.